That is so cool. It's Chris, my plan. Chaos in the house of Willem Pugmire. That's a musical work of art. Bollocks the bloody light. See, I hate the bright light. I'm always fiddling with the lighting on these vlogs. A work of art, and a very excellent work of art, inspired by H.P. Lovecraft. Musical work of art inspired by the music of Eric Zahn. Isn't that cool? Now, what I'm reading tonight is a portion of a short story that I am working on. The short story is a sequel to a Robert Bloch story called The Cheaters. And yet I have introduced a character who is inspired by the character of Eric Zahn in Lovecraft's story. So I hopefully my audio is in sync. I really hate when that happens, when the audio is out of sync with when you're talking, and you know what I mean. It's that vlog I just did, the audio was out of sync. Really sucks. Why does that happen here at YouTube? Anyway, I'm going to continue with reading more of the revision to my story that I wrote tonight. And this will introduce the character that I have based on H.P. Lovecraft's character of Eric Zahn, the viol player. Alright, if I can get things together here. Alright. He listened to the rain and to the distant humming of a soft human sound that came from some place near, resisting once more the urge to investigate Van Prin's desk. Sebastian turned to the door, which had not been closed, and walked into the dim hallway. He followed the sound two doors down and knocked. The melody swiftly died, and a high voice rasped, "Entrez!" Sebastian pushed open the door and entered the room, gazing at the back of the man who sat upon a stool and looked out a window into night. One slim taper burned on a desk near to where the fellow sat, and the old man motioned with a hand to the chair at that desk. Going to that chair, Sebastian sat. "Can you smell the starlight?" asked a high and wizened voice. A withered hand reached for the teacup that sat on the window's sill, and the old man drained the cup of its contents and then returned it to its place before the pane. "They've been obscured by storm, yet I smell them still, the stars." How frail that high, thin voice sounded as it spoke. The figure turned to face Sebastian, one hand massaging a thin throat. "Are you ill?" The elderly man shook with subtle mirth. "Only with a dread disease, mortality." Sebastian took in the skinny old man, who sat crookedly on the tall stool. He noticed the violin on the floor beside the stool. The hand remained at the scrawny neck. "I'm still getting used to the gift of speech," he said, smiling as he shrugged. "It is a painful process. May I pour you some more tea? Is that your herbal remedy?"
No.
"The tea serves other purposes. The pain is part of the bargain with the beast. He offered me the gift of gab, with subtle pain the price to pay. I don't mind. It's wonderful to hear the words from my mouth instead of merely in my head. The beast, is that what you call him? Did he kidnap you as well? Night wind shook at the window, and some elemental thing slipped through a tiny crevice, chilling the room a little and causing the candlelight to flicker and dim.
Do you call it kidnapping? Wasn't it rather seduction?
He doesn't coerce. He beguiles. He finds you when there is little left to live for, and he instructs you in your uncanny art, whatever it may be. Thus we aid the aura of this veil. The fellow began to cough, and Sebastian went to him, placed his arm around him, and helped him off the stool. You need to rest. Let me help you to bed.
Oh, heavens, bed!
That is not the safest place in Sesqua Valley, my friend. It encourages dreaming. You want to guard your dreaming in this land, believe me. No, seat me in the chair you have vacated. I shall rest my head in my arms and think of the new music I must compose. Yes, there we are. Thank you. He's given you the middle room, I think. It's quite comfortable. You may be happy there. Good night. He turned his back to Sebastian and cupped his face in his hands. The younger man backed to the door and exited the room. Despite his keen desire to talk about this place to which he had been lured. All right, I shall stop there. I shall see if I'm still recording. Oh boy, still got a few minutes. So, there is my introduction to a character named Jean-Éric Le Seul, obviously inspired by the music of Eric Zahn. That wonderful story. Lovecraft inspires artists. It is magnificent. He inspired this wonderful piano piece by this brilliant musician. He inspires writers. He inspired Robert Bloch, August Derleth, Brian Lumley. The list goes on and on and on. Lovecraft, for me, he is the sacred font, if I may quote Henry James. He is the font of inspiration that never dries. And it is my job and my pleasure to write stories that are inspired by this font of inspiration, this font of literary art, this genius who we call H.P. Lovecraft, Esquire. So, I'm off to bed to do some dreaming and to think more about this new story. I encourage you artists to write, to weave your music, to create. It's the greatest gift we can give to the world, our art.